Check, check, check.
Glory to God. Anybody know he reigns in here? Hallelujah. Anybody know he reigns in here? Oh, no, don't seem like it. Come on. Does anybody in here know that our God reigns? Come on, just for a minute, could you stand on your feet and give our honorees, a man and woman of God, a big hand clap of praise and just begin to let God know that he reigns in this place? Come on, God reigns in this place. We are here to celebrate, hallelujah. We are here to glorify God, hallelujah. Mr. Brown said it's a celebrate. Some of y'all look like y'all come here to celebrate. I came to celebrate today. I came to honor the man and woman of God today. I came to glorify God today. I came to lift his name up today because he is worthy of all the praise, all the honor, and all the glory. Oh, my God, my God, my God, my God. Oh, my God, my God, my God. I'm so glad I know who I am. Oh, glory to God. I'm so glad he reigning in this place. Oh, my God, hallelujah. Father, we bless you in this place, oh God. We bless you in this place, oh God. We thank you that you reign in this place, oh God, over all circumstance, God. And I begin to plead the blood right now, Lord God, over every spirit that is not like you, oh God. Every sad spirit in here, oh God. Every seducing spirit, oh God. I plead your blood right now, oh God. We take authority right now. We take dominion right now. We tell the devil to go back to hell where he came from. Oh my God, you reign in this place, oh God. Oh God, hey, in the name of Jesus, I rebuke every tickling ear. In the name of Jesus, I rebuke every bad itch. In the name of Jesus, I rebuke every spirit desire. A hoop in the name of Jesus. I rebuke every religious spirit, every traditional spirit. I plead the blood now. I come against it now in the mighty name of Jesus. And Father, you be glorified in this place. You be glorified. You be glorified. You be glorified. Woo, you be glorified. Woo, you be glorified. Hey, you be glorified. You be glorified in the shift. You be glorified in the shaking. You be glorified in the making. You be glorified in the breaking. Woo, I see you, God. Hey, I see you, God. Yeah, I see. Yeah, yeah, boss. Okay. I see you, God. Yeah, 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 yeah. Y'all can sit down. Oh my God, my God, my God, my God, my God. But I saw the shift you were talking about. I'm planning on teaching today. I'm planning on doing whatever the Lord called me to do today. But I saw that shift you was talking about. And see, the enemy is against a shift. The enemy is against God getting ready to turn things around. The enemy is against anything getting ready to be broke. Any yoke getting ready to be destroyed. The enemy comes against that. And I know everybody don't get up and shout. And I know everybody don't get up and do all this and do all that kind of dancing. But look like if you love God and look like you come to celebrate, you will show some sign that you come to. Oh my God, my God, my God. Oh, I wish I had leaders like this when I was growing up. I wish I had leaders like this. I'm getting that word. I said, I wish I had leaders like this when I was growing up. Could nobody make me sit down and be quiet? Oh my God, I'll beat them kidding up. Could nobody make me stop shouting? Could nobody make me stop lavishing them with gifts? I'd be up shouting all over this church. Oh my God, my God, my God. Oh my God. Look like some folks done forgot. Ah. Yeah, 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 yeah. I see the shift. Woo, I see the shift. I see the kingdom shift. that is going on in this nation. I see the kingdom shift that is going on in this county. I see the kingdom shift that is going on in this city. Oh my God, in the name of Jesus. I see the authority, glory to God. I see the dominion. It's already taking place, glory to God. It has already begun, but I see it even more. My God, this is the apostolic ministry, right? Wait, hold on. What Kingdom Connection folks at? Now, I know we apostolic folks. We got to do some teaching. Hello, somebody. We got to be fed the word of God. But I got the preacher. But we don't mind shouting either, do we? We don't mind speaking in no tongues. We don't mind glorifying God. Can you take out a few minutes? I don't need you to hype me up. But can you take out a few seconds and give God your best praise, your best worship, your best dance? Now, hear where the problem lies. Excuse me. Hear where the problem lies. No. Hear where the problem lies. It ain't your day. Excuse me. It ain't your day. It's Apostle and Lady Ross Day. What you talking about? Some of y'all can't celebrate because, excuse me. See, if you're blessed man or woman of God, at least get up and dance and shout. See, when you were out there in the street, could nobody stop you from getting down, boogie, woogie, woogie? Could nobody stop you from doing it wrong? Could nobody stop you? Get your breakthrough. Get your breakthrough. Get your breakthrough. You say, I came to honor Apostle Nim, but go on, get your breakthrough. I came to honor Apostle Nim, but go on, get your. See, that was your chance to get your breakthrough. That was your chance to get your breakthrough. When you come to bless a man and woman of God, hallelujah, and you celebrate like you crazy, like you done lost your mind, there's an opportunity to get your breakthrough. Honey, your day might come, but this is their day, and you ought to celebrate them like you ain't never celebrated before. You had an opportunity to get your breakthrough on today. Some of y'all sitting on your breakthrough. Oh my God, my God, my God. Y'all sit down. Oh my God, my God, my God. My God, my God, my God. Folk wondering why they can't be blessed. I got to preach. Folk wondering why they ain't blessed. Folk wondering why stuff ain't coming. Wondering why things ain't broke you yet. Broke through yet. Honey, you got to break them through. And you break them through beginning about honoring God and honoring the man of God. That's how. Okay, stop, y'all. Okay. See, they going to a whole nother level. Okay, I got to. I'm trying to get to the KCC. You ain't seen nothing yet. Let me preach. Apostle, y'all ready to travel? Y'all ready to travel? Y'all ready to travel? Whew, yeah, the season is coming. Y'all already got some folk that can handle things while y'all gone. I've seen that, glory to God. But get ready to travel. Now, I ain't the type preacher, I don't try to make folk feel good. I don't try to tell folk what they want to hear. I say what thus said the Lord. Hallelujah. When the Lord told me this a while back, hallelujah, what he was getting ready to do with the Rosses, hallelujah. My God, my God, my God. Okay. Go on to Hebrew. Go on to Hebrew 13. Glory to God. Do my best not to be before you long. I know it's been a long day and y'all ready to get out of here. Hallelujah. Hebrews 13:7. Glory to God. Just had to remind some of y'all because some of y'all don't seem like you to forget. This, it ain't about you. It's not about you. Hallelujah. This day is not about you. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I ain't got nothing to say. They got enough already. The devil is a lie. I don't even know what was asked. How they gonna ask us for? Okay, excuse me, you know, how they gonna ask us for this, and how they gonna ask us for that, and how we got the, why we got the. And you see, and miss folk that love you. Okay, excuse me. Okay. In the midst of folk that love you, there's some folk that don't care much for you. Some folk just hanging around for the benefits. Okay. Am I telling the truth? Because they see the anointing. And they enjoying the teaching and they enjoying the preaching, but they hanging around for the benefits. Just wanted to remind some folks on the day that hello somebody. Don't just hang around for the benefits, but you better hear the word of the Lord. Chapter 13, verse 7. Y'all with me? I'm reading out a New King James Version, and it reads as, remember those who rule over you, who have spoken the word of God to you, whose faith follow, considering the outcome of their conduct. Hallelujah. It's that considering the outcome of their conduct. They didn't jump on over here with me to chapter verse 17. Y'all there? Verse 17, it says, obey. It said, remember. Now it says, obey. Somebody got to get in line in here today. Excuse me, somebody. It says, obey those who rule over you. That the rule is, again, everybody don't like that word right there. Everybody don't like that right there. Who rule over you and be submissive. It said, obey. Then it says, those who rule over you. And then it said, be submissive.
Those are some hard words for some folks right there. He says, but they watch out for your souls as those who must give an account. It says, let them do so with joy and not with grief, for that would be unprofitable for you. I want to use as a subject real quick, protectors of the anointing. You may be seated. Protectors of the anointing. Apostle Ralston, y'all came on down to Moffat, Tennessee, praise God, and hit us with that word, said the secret anointing. And he preached that thing. It was good. That was a rich word. Hallelujah. And I said, Lord, what do you want me to preach about when I going on back down there, going on down there? What you want me to preach about? And he said, protectors of the anointing. I tried to get around it, and I tried to get around. I'm just going to tell it like it is. I tried to get around that word because sometimes you look at folk and it seems like everything is all grand. I'm just saying like it. It looked like everything is all grand. Hallelujah. You look at folk, you see folk come in full. Y'all came in full. Oh, my God. Y'all just packed the house when you came to CTS. I'm saying this for a reason. But at the same time, every kingdom going through something. Every church going through something. Every church got some folk doing what they ain't got no business doing. Every church got some folk with one foot in the door and one foot out the door. And every church got somebody that want to tell the pastor what to do. Every church got somebody that want to take the first lady's place. Woo, y'all. I just got to preach what the Lord then told me to preach. Everybody don't want to hear the truth. Everybody ain't here just for the teaching. Again, some folks here just for the benefits, the kingdom benefits, the blessing that is on your life, the goodness of God that is on your life. Some folks here just for the food. Okay. Let me. I don't want to get ahead of myself. Let me give you the purpose. The purpose of this here word is to teach/preach that God has anointed those that He chose to do great works in His kingdom. Hello, somebody. He's anointed those He chose to do great works in His kingdom. However, the anointing/gift/calling must be protected in order to be effective. Let me read that again. God has anointed those. He chose to do great works in His kingdom. However, the anointing/gift/calling must be protected to be effective. It's anointed people in here besides Lady Ross and besides Apostle Ross. There's some more anointed folk in here. But just because you anointed, glory to God, don't mean you don't need no covering. And just because you are, y'all quiet. Just because you anointed don't mean it can't nobody tell you what. Okay. Let me tell you what the protectors are. Protectors can include apostles, pastors, teachers, parents, teachers, friends, mentors, and also counselors. A protector is a person, place, or thing that protects or is intended to protect. That protects or is intended, I'm going to go somewhere in a minute, to protect. That protects or is intended to protect. Your apostle, your lady, Ross, your first lady can try to protect you, but everybody don't want to be protected. Everybody don't want to be protected. They say they do. But everybody don't want to, y'all, you in the house, right? I know some of y'all are already mad, but that's all right. I'm going to preach anyway. Everybody, cause you know why? Only the Bible, that's a song to say, ain't nobody mad but the devil. I got to praise. There's some folk in here who don't want to hear this word, and they're going to tune it out in just a minute. But I'm telling you, you need to listen, because I'm about to show you in the word of God what happened to somebody who got half-cocked, who was anointed. My God, God had changed their heart and everything. But because they got the big head, because the heart wasn't in the right place after God had changed it, they began. The anointing was canceled. The assignment was canceled. Be careful how you look at your own anointing in the mirror. Hello, somebody. So protect. The word protect, a person, place, a thing that protects or is intended to protect, a protector. And then the word protect means to cover or shield from something that would destroy or injure. You hear that? To cover or shield. Somebody ain't listening. To cover or shield from something. You might not know what it is, but your protector know what it is. From something that would, look, destroy or injure. Not elevate you. Not put you in a place where you want to be, but would destroy or injure you. Then the second part of the definition is, it means to guard. Hello, somebody. And then you got the anointing. And the anointing, a special endowment, a special empowerment by the Holy Spirit. Where's she going with this? I'm going to show you in a minute. So you got to be, in order for you to be effective in your anointing, you got to be protected. And then the word effective means producing or able to produce a desired result. Well, who is the desired result coming from? Your protector of your anointing is trying to teach you, because there is a certain place in your anointing that you ought to go. But if you are not covered, if you are not shielded, if you are not guarded, you will never get to that place that it is expected of you to go. Let's go to 1 Samuel. Or Samuel. Oh, my God, my God, my God. Ooh. For Samuel. 27. Starting at verse 27. Some of y'all ain't got no Bible. Ain't got no iPad. Apostle, don't bite her back no more. You can't tell him what to do. I know you word based. That's why I said some of y'all ain't got no Bible. I have to tell my folks that sometimes. Where your Bible at? And then if you ain't no member here, you at the house of God. You ought to have a Bible. They already showed you what the usher's at. You ought to be raising your hands. Usher, I need a Bible. We waiting to be tickled. Amen. Give me something I can feel. No, not today. If you're going to feel anything here, it's going to be real, and it's going to be the word of God. Because your blood, while I'm preaching this word, and if I don't preach what God told me to preach, the blood is going to be on my hands, and ain't no blood going to be on my hand today. My subtitle says, Saul anointed king. Verse 27 says, and as they were going down to the outskirts of the city, Samuel said to Saul, tell the servants to go on ahead of us. See, everybody ain't got no business hearing everything going on. Y'all, can I teach and do this all at the same time? All right. He said, tell the servant to tell the other folk going on ahead of us. And he said, he went on and said, but you stand here a while. Hello, somebody. Folks try to run up out the church real quick. He said, but you stand here a while that I may announce to you the word of God. Hello, somebody. I'm going to read some more. I just want you to let that soak in just a little bit. Stay here and let everybody else go on. And you stay here a while for a certain time limit. And let me announce the word of God to you. This was Samuel talking to Saul the king. Did I not tell you? I'm sorry, y'all. 1 Samuel chapter 9, verse 27. Stay here a while. Stay in my presence a while so I can announce to you the word of God. Let me tell you what thus saith the Lord. Okay. Then verse chapter 10. I'm in chapter 10 now. Y'all got that? Chapter 10, verse 1. It said, and then Samuel was a high priest, y'all. Samuel was a high priest. He was a prophet. Pretty much whatever Samuel said, it went. Okay. Whatever Samuel said, I done stepped on some toes already, y'all. Whatever Samuel said, because he was a high priest and because he was a prophet, I'll see, baby, look for kill, I'd be dead. Because he was a high priest, and look, and because of his reputation, did we not just read that in Hebrews? Because of his reputation, everybody that knew Samuel, my God, knew that Samuel wasn't no prophet liar. Everybody that knew Samuel didn't play no games. Now, Samuel had, his house was a little out of order, but Samuel didn't play no games. Samuel didn't have time to pity-pat with folk. Samuel told it like it was. Apostles are meant to tell it like it is. You got some folks. See, everybody, many are called, but few are chosen. I'm going somewhere else with that. You got a whole lot of folk giving themselves names, but it is the apostle that the Lord calls. Folk walking around with all kind of titles. And folk want all kind of folk. We got all kind of titles. But you got to let the Lord tell you who he done called, who he done sent. Okay. See, the respect just ought to be there. I don't care what you're going through. Then Samuel took a flask of oil and he poured it on his head. God had already told Samuel some stuff about Saul. On a flask of oil, and he said, pour it on his head, and he kissed him. And he said, is this not because the Lord, look, is this not because the Lord has anointed you commander over his inheritance? Hold on, wait a minute. Samuel, the high priest, the prophet, is anointing someone to be king who can tell other folks what to do. Look, who can tell other folks what to do, but at the same time, he said, has the Lord given you, has the Lord anointed you commander over his inheritance? The children of Israel. God said, I'm giving you my inheritance. Hello, somebody. I'm showing you how special you are, Saul. But the person that is anointing you is greater than you are. Okay, some of y'all. Okay. All right. Jump on with me. Jump on down to verse 5. I want to show you where I'm going. I'm going to show you where some of us mess up when we get anointed. I'm going to show you some of y'all looking like, what? I'm going to show you what some of us mess up when we get anointed, because I messed up. I'm going to show you what we mess up when we get anointed. Because when we get anointed, you got some power. You got some authority. Yeah, you've been endued. Glory to God. Thank you for the Holy Ghost. Hello, somebody. Thank God for all that. But still, somebody, God had put somebody over your anointing. Okay. Verse 5. Yeah. Oh, thank you, Holy Ghost. Verse 5 says, after this, after all the stuff they had talked about and all, verse 5 says, after that you shall come to the hill of God, where the Philistine garrison is, and it'll happen when you have come there to the city, look, that you will meet a group of prophets. Oh, he in there now. He in there now. He in there now. You will meet a group of prophets coming down from the high place. Oh, sha-ta-da-da-ta. Uh-huh. Yeah, we get to hang out with the wrong folk. Excuse me. From the high place, it said, with a string instrument, a tambourine, a flute, and a harp before them. And it says, and they will be prophesied. Verse 6 says, then the Spirit of the Lord will come upon you. Uh-huh. Yeah, uh-oh. And you will prophesy. Oh, sha-ta-da-da-ta-ta. With them and be turned into another man, and let it be when these signs come on you that you do as the occasion demands. Well, in other words, do what the Lord tells you to do. Y'all see that? When the Spirit of the Lord come on you, do what the Lord tell you to do. A lot of folks lie and say, God told me to do this, and Apostle God said that, and Lady God said, time for me to leave. Okay. God says it's time for, I ought to be doing this right now. Don't be lying, oh God. That's probably something you want to do. That ain't what God said, because God going to tell your protector, hello somebody, before he tell. It's in the word. It's in the word. He told Samuel, he told Saul, before Saul knew anything about him getting ready to be anointed, God had already told Samuel what he was going to do and who he was going to meet. Oh, this word is good to me. Might not be good to you, but it's good to me. Oh, glory to God. Oh, yeah. Verse 8 says, he said, you shall go down before me to Gilgal. Listen, and certainly he didn't remember he got anointed. He didn't got anointed, amen. You shall, look at what Samuel told him. He said, you shall go down before me to Gilgal, and surely I will come down to you I'm going to do this, to offer burnt offerings and make sacrifices of peace offerings. He said, 7 days you shall wait. It didn't hit. Look. He said, 7 days you shall wait. He didn't tell him what to do after 7 days. You see that? 7 days you shall wait till I come to you and look and show you. And show you what you should do. Didn't ask you to write no manual down on what you're supposed to be doing. Didn't ask you to do nothing there. He said, go down there and wait on me. Oh, my God, my God, my God. Now run on chapter 13. Oh, my God, my God. He done got his instruction, right? Don't y'all go to sleep now. Sound like y'all ready to go to sleep. Because you need to hear this. And you need to see this. He done got anointed. Not only was he anointed, but he was given instruction on his anointment. Y'all, that's what an apostle does. That's what apostles do. That's what leaders do. They don't just let you get anointed, but they give you instructions on what to do with what you just received. See, a lot of folk in the church, I'm going to move on. A lot of folk in the church will get anointed, get anointed, let me go, get anointed. The Holy Spirit will anoint them. They filled with the Holy Ghost, walking around speaking tongues. Hello, somebody. Trying to tell everybody else what to do because they've been anointed. and then would turn around and leave the place of assignment. Oh, my, 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 my. I heard the sister, I heard her testifying. And I ain't saying this because she testified. Will leave the place of assignment where they have been anointed and appointed. They ain't been appointed over there in the church where it hold 25,000 people. They ain't been appointed over there. But they were anointed right here at Kingdom Connection Church where they found out the real meaning of the kingdom and not just going to church. Not just singing in the choir, not just serving on a usher board, not just serving on a motherboard, but they found out what it was really like to live in the kingdom and do what God said to without restrictions of religion. Y'all lost some of y'all right there. You cannot survive and thrive under a kingdom ministry with a religious and traditional mentality. You got to go. They ain't got to ask you to leave. Y'all quiet in here. Apostle them ain't got to ask you to leave. But because you so used to the morning bank type. Some folk get so used to, oh, hello, somebody, where you came from. The deacon got up on Sunday and said the same prayer every Sunday. Didn't sound like nothing. Didn't mean nothing. Oh, it was blabber jabber, yada, yada, yada. Couldn't nobody feel nothing because there wasn't no Holy Ghost in that. Y'all quiet. Oh, ain't nobody mad but the devil. Pastor, why I can't get no breakthrough? Every time I die to do good, even always, I get sicker. I used to get sicker hearing that. Line up with the kingdom, baby, and you will begin to be blessed as the Beatitudes say. You'll begin to see blessings and everything going wrong in your life. You will begin to see how blessed you are because you're in the kingdom. Okay, oh, boy. Ooh, and some of my CTS folks back today ain't said nothing. Ain't said nothing either. Yeah, I get on y'all. Honey, you better stop going with the flow. The devil is a lie. Because I'm going to get y'all when I get back to CTS. I'm going with no flow. You went with the flow long enough. Honey, it's time to get with the kingdom program. You want to get blessed, get with the kingdom program. You want to get out of your mess, get with the kingdom program. Ain't nobody got no time for no religious stuff. Ain't nobody got no time for no tradition stuff. That's why some of you, oh my God. That's why some folks can't stop sleeping around. Can't stop laying it down. Can't stop pulling your pants off in places you ain't got no business pulling your pants off. Because you're so messed up with traditional spirits passed up in the pulpit, preaching from the church you came to, calling everybody in the church. Deacon standing around the corner smoking cigarettes. And wonder why folk can't get delivered. Don't want to listen. Don't want to follow no instruction. Been anointed and that's all. Went up there, got filled with the Holy Ghost, stayed in the line. Always. You got some folks always in the prayer line. But ain't nothing changing. Because all they want is a feel good. Tell me something going to make me feel good. Because my pastor at the church I I used to go to, he hooped all the time, but he was coding everything in the church. He ain't gonna say nothing about fornication, cause he doing it. He ain't gonna say nothing about gambling, cause he know other folk doing it, and he don't wanna say nothing, because they gonna stop paying their tax. Yo. Don't let no sister come and say, Pastor, I saw Deacon around there. I saw Deacon around there smoking cigarettes and cussing. And I saw Sister so-and-so and Minister so-and-so down at the hotel. Baby, don't worry about it. Let God, if I'm lying, I'm tired. Hello, somebody. It's happening all over the place. Put money in a place they ain't got no business to put no money in. Oh, my God. And the pastor ain't going to say nothing. Because they big tithers. They wasn't appointed in by God. They were voted in by the church. And the church folk, all they knew was church. They say they knew Jesus, but they didn't know Jesus because they didn't know his principles. And they didn't know his principle because they didn't spend time in his word. And they didn't spend time in his word because they didn't know if they liked him or not. All they knew is that when he gave them stuff, he was fine with them. And when he didn't give them stuff, they wasn't no Christians for real. They really wasn't no believers. So they were appointed by folk who didn't know nothing but church. And because they didn't know nothing about church, surely they won't point somebody who don't know nothing about church except for the preliminaries. Hello, somebody. They were only going to, you are pointing what you are. You vote in what you are. Y'all quiet. You vote in what you are. If you good for nothing, full of hell, don't mind selling it. Hello, somebody. Don't mind doing all the evil stuff that everybody else is doing. You're going to vote in the same kind of person because you're going to go and tell Pastor, him or her, you know what? Before you came, we didn't do no stuff like that. This how we did it before you came. I don't see nothing in the Bible about no deacons being no head of the church. How you gonna call a pastor in a meeting and tell a pastor what to preach? The devil is a lie straight from the pit of hell. The pastor gonna go to hell, and the folk in the church gonna go to hell too, because they believe in what the folk in the... And folk ain't gonna go nowhere. Oh my God. Folk ain't gonna go nowhere too quick in that traditional church. It's hard to get rid of, oh, why did I get over here? It's hard to get rid of folk in a traditional church. Because they... Why go somewhere? Why leave? Why leave? Everything, you're doing whatever you want to do. You come to church when you get ready. Supposed to be teaching Sunday school, been teaching Sunday school 10, 15 years, and still going to the club on Saturday night. I might not be what I should be, but I ain't what I used to be. I just ask the Lord to work on me, Lord. You don't want God to work on you. That's a lie. It's life. I'm talking about, I just ask God. No. Do you really? If you really want God to work on you, if he know you ain't got to kill you. Lie if you want to. I just really with the Lord. And then you've been put, oh God, and you've been put in a situation where you have been anointed. And God sees your heart. No, you ain't going to change. No, all you're doing is playing games with him. God will kill you. Y'all didn't like that, did you? He killed Ananias and Sapphira. Get a whole lot of folk. He the same guy. Yesterday, today, and forevermore. He wasn't playing back then, and he ain't playing now. That's why all the corruption is going on in the world right now, because anything goes. I ain't gonna marry no two women, no two men. The devil is a lie. Take me to court, sue me, throw me in jail. I don't care. Baby, I will smile while I pray while I'm in jail until the jail cell come open. Let me wrap this thing up. He gave us instructions. Gave him instructions. Oh, yes, it is. But I'm one of those pastors that I just refuse to see folk I know and love die and go to hell. And I know y'all the same way. Die and go to hell when you can speak a word of truth into their lives. And not only speak a word of truth into life, but live a life that you preach about and live a life that you teach about. How do you expect your whole household to get saved when you living like you ain't saved? God said, okay, let me get on up here. I don't know where I'm at. Okay. Well, man, 10 to 7? 13. 13 to 7. Okay. Oh, my God. Verse 7, y'all there? And then it says, and some of the Hebrews crossed over the Jordan to the land of Gad and Gilead, and asked for Saul. He was still in Gilgal. He did that right. Hello? At least I did that right. That ain't good enough. Yeah, okay, D. And it said, and all the people followed him trembling. Look at verse 8. And then he waited 7 days. He did that. According to the time set by Samuel, but Samuel did not come to Gilgal, and the people were scattered from him, from Saul, verse 9. So Saul said, bring a burnt offering and a peace offering here to me. So he didn't got out of his place. That wasn't his place. Okay, let me move on. Verse 10 says, look, now it happened as soon as he had finished presenting the burnt offering that Samuel, the protector of his anointing, hello, came and
And Saul went out to meet him. I can give it that. Ain't that like folk right there that do know they did something wrong? They'll come out to meet you because they on the way they making up a story, on the way making up an excuse as to why they did what they did. What? Boy, there's some manipulating folk up in the church. Anointing. And will manipulate your shoes off your feet. Know you know the word of God. Know you got a relationship with God. Know you the protector of their anointing. But will still try to play you for a fool. Okay, Daddy. I got some folk like that in my church. Oh. Don't matter how much I done taught them. When they get in trouble and they know I'm going to call them to the office, or they know Co-Pastor Lord going to call them to the office, will make up an excuse and try to get out of it. And evil, y'all, they mad at me. Oh, y'all know, I don't care about y'all. And we'll try to make up a lie. God done already told me what you were going to say. He done already told me how you're going to act. But you're going to... The protector of your anointing will see you coming in line from a mile away. Okay. Oh... Oh, my. Okay, where I'm at, y'all? Verse 11? Am I at 11? I'm finna wrap it up. 11? Okay, came out to meet and to greet, that he might, came out to meet him, that he might greet him. Verse 11 says, and Samuel said, what have you done? Okay. You better say that, mother. Hello, somebody. I'm trying to help somebody in here. You better stop that lying to your apostle and first lady. You better stop that lying to your co-pastor. Okay, all right. Saul said, here you go. When I saw that the people were scattered from me, and that you did not come within the days appointed, and that, look, laugh, and that the Philistines gathered together at Mishmash, verse 12 said, then I said, not the Holy Ghost, he had the Holy Ghost. He said, then I said, the Philistines will now come down on me at Gilgal, and I have not made supplication to the Lord. The devil is a lie. You just want to show folk who he was. It wasn't about trying to make no supplication. Pastor, y'all was running late, and I just came and got started, even though you told us not to get started before y'all came. Okay. Ooh, okay. My. Okay. He said, therefore, I felt compelled. What you say, Apostle? It was all in my spirit. Oh, my God. Hey. Who are you trying to convince? Hey. What, you stomping roaches? Who are you trying to? It was all in my spirit. Because the word of God said, did you want to get a sermon it? That ain't going to cover up the lie. Oh. He said, therefore I felt compelled. And an offer to burn offering. And look at what Samuel told him. Verse 13. And Samuel said to Saul, you have done foolishly. He called him a fool.
Ain't nobody gonna say nothing. Pastor better not call me no fool. Lady Ross better not call me no fool. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Hello, y'all ain't saying nothing. He said, you don't act foolishly. In order to act like a fool, so we done got all sanctified now. If you act like a fool, you must be a fool. Your anointing ain't got nothing to do with you acting like no fool. God done stepped back and watching you acting like a fool. He ain't got no part. Okay. He said, you have not kept the commandment of the Lord. He didn't say of me. He said, not a, he didn't say, he said, you have not kept the commandment of the Lord. That's what I love about apostles. I'm talking about God appointed apostles and God, yeah, both of y'all. That's what I'm doing. We ain't going to say what I said. It's what God said. Whew. Okay. You've not kept the appointment, kept the commandment of the Lord your God, which he commanded you. For now, look. For now the Lord would have established. Your kingdom over Israel forever, but now your kingdom shall not continue. The Lord has sought for himself. You already been canceled. The Lord has sought for himself a man after his own heart, and the Lord has commanded him to be commander over his people. Why? Because you have not kept what the Lord commanded you. Let me give you these pointers. I'm going to sit down. Because y'all already got your praise on, right? If you're able to write these down, I want you to write these down just in case you find yourself in this situation. Those who are anointed are, number one, confirmed by God. Number two, sealed by God, which indicates A, ownership, and B, security. Those who are anointed are, number one, confirmed by God. Number two, sealed by God, which indicates A, ownership, and B, security. Another pointer. When the anointing is canceled, the assignment is canceled. Protectors, next point. Protectors of the anointing are assigned to pinpoint weapons of mass destruction in the lives of those they protect, and then destroy the weapons. Some of y'all didn't even get that. Protectors of the anointing are assigned to pinpoint. What's wrong with you? Which are weapons of mass destruction in the lives of those they protect, and then destroy them. The weapons, that is. And the next point says, protectors see with spiritual eyes of discernment to choose who God has chosen us to protect. Protectors of the anointing. That's the word of God. Come on, give the Lord one hand, come and play. Praise. I want to say this before I take my seat. If you're in here today and you know you've been hard-headed, you know you've been out of order, you know you have tried to buck the system against your leaders,
then you need to confess. Oh, y'all ain't gonna say nothing. You need to apologize to your leaders. And it needs to be from the bottom of your heart. And it needs to be real. Why? Because you will find yourself on a battlefield leading to your death. That's what happened to Saul. He ended up on the battlefield. And he died. All that God planned for him, he messed it up. Because he decided he did not want to obey those that had rule over him. So if you're in here today, you need to seek the Lord right now. And then you need to make an open confession. You need to come and tell your leaders that you are sorry. I'm talking about my CTS folks too. You need to apologize on today. And I'm talking about that thing need to be for real. Why, Apostle? Because Saul went to Samuel and pretended like he was sorry, but he really wasn't. And he still lost his place because of his disobedience. Now, I know without a shadow of any doubt, there's some folk in here like that. And the old folks just said, a monkey on your back. And he ain't gonna come off until you repent. Until you confess that that's you. And you need to be moving in the right direction on today. And if there's anybody in here who has not given their life to the Lord, anybody in here who has backslidden, will you come? Apostle, is that okay? Will you come? If you backslidden, if you don't know the Lord, will you come today? The Lord wants to deliver you. He's in this place. Don't leave out of here the way you came. You came in here not in the right shape, not in the right place, out of order. Don't leave out of here today. The Bible said that the angels in heaven rejoice over one sinner that repents and gives their life back to the Lord. Hallelujah. But if I open up a prayer line, I ain't doing it. God ain't said it. I ain't opening up no prayer line. Because we want to be blessed, but we don't want to come out of our mess. God is willing and God is able. But it's up to you to make up in your mind. Hallelujah. Come on, give the Lord a hand clap of praise. Thank you, ministers. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you.
Mackenzie, what a word that will save the sin sick soul. Amen. Amen. That's a yes, Lord message. Yes, Lord. You're in the place, you're in the house, you're in the city, you're in the state, you're in our nation. With that message, amen. Amen. The church, it's time for the church to rise up. Rise up, rise and shine. Hallelujah. 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 I understand why the press for the praise and the worship. I understand. We hear many words, but that's a word you need to hold on to. It'll save your soul, save some souls. Amen. Time is winding up, church. Be ye holy, for I am holy. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you. Thank you, Apostle. Yes, it was raining in here. Raining, washing. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you. Hallelujah. How can they hear without a preacher? How can we preach and let she be sent? Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. She obeyed God in this house. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. She obeyed God, church. She obeyed God. Then you have ears to hear what the Spirit of the Lord has said in this place. Yes, Lord Spirit. Yes, Lord. Yes, to your will. Yes, to your way. I surrender all. I surrender. You know, that's what we got to do. Surrender. Surrender. Let some of that stuff go that's holding us hostage. Hallelujah. I surrender, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Oh God, we pray right now. In the name of Jesus. As this vessel is refilled, refreshed, we bind anything that Satan would try to do to come against this vessel. But Lord God, we pray and plead the blood of Jesus. From the crown of her head to the soles of her feet. Refill, restore, pour fresh oil, fresh oil, fresh oil, fresh oil, fresh oil. Hallelujah. Glory. Glory. Yeah, 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 yeah. The steps of a good man are ordered of the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God's got it. God's got it. The victory's already won. God's got it. Ha! God's got it. Hallelujah. Somebody ought to say, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for that word of deliverance. That word to set me free. Hallelujah. Yeah. Ha! Yeah, yeah, yeah. Gotta know what time it is, amen? Discern the seasons. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, glory. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. It is well. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Some chains been broken up in here. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, God, we thank you. Hallelujah. 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 Let me hear you sing it. Sister Barbara Ann. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yeah. Get a book. Hallelujah. See, I know what the program says, but we already established from the beginning. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Lord, you're worthy. 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 Lord, you're holy. Lord, you're holy. Lord, you're holy. Lord, you're holy. You're so holy, Lord. Lord, you're holy. Lord, you're mighty. Lord, you're mighty. Lord, my. Lord, you're mighty. Lord, Lord, we thank you. Thank you. Lord, we thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. Lord, we praise you. Praise. Lord, we praise you. Lord, we praise you. Lord, Lord, we love you. We love, oh Lord, Lord, we love. We just love you, Lord, because you first loved us. Lord, we love you. We love, Lord, we love you. We love you, Lord. We just love you, Lord. Lord, we love you. We love you. Lord, we love you. We just love you, Lord. We love you, Lord. Lord, you're so worthy. Lord, Lord. Lord, you're worthy. You're mighty, mighty, mighty worthy, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah is the highest praise. Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Oh, God. They that worship the Lord must worship the Lord in spirit and in truth. Amen. At this time, we're going to ask for the presentation of gifts. Amen.
Amen. Praise God. Praise God. Excuse me. Those of you that have gifts, if you would come stand to my right at this time. Amen. I could use that gift. Hey. This pastor's. Mm-hmm. Amen. Apostle and lady, if y'all would stand. Come on and celebrate our angels. My pastor is why everybody needs a pastor. Amen. We love you, Apostle Ross. We love you, Lady Ross. We come today to pause. Let me say this. Our pastor don't even want this day. Our first lady don't even want this day. She's like, look, y'all do what y'all do. We eat, go home. You know, we can watch some TV or eat some fish. Or we ain't got to be having no program. But we want to celebrate them. We want to celebrate you. We want to celebrate and honor you. If I could shower you with the whole world, I would. Silver and gold have I none. But what we do have, we give freely. And we come before the prophet today to lay gifts at your feet and shower you with gifts.
To our wonderful lady and pastor and lady. I said lady first because pastor, no, we don't have anything right in here for him. This bag, lady, is you, I thought, and it's full of goodies. It's full of goodies. Trust me when I tell y'all, it's full of goodies. I kind of rolled them military style so I can get it all in here. Now, it's up to her if she wants to show it, but this bag is from the wonderful Wonder Women, every Wonder Woman in here, and that's all of KCC ladies. This is from the Wonder Women, and also everybody needs this. Everybody needs this. And it's just a little token to show you that we love you.
And I'm to represent the Ursha Board. We know that we haven't did a lot, but we just wanted to show our love and appreciation for y'all today.
Amen. I am standing on behalf of our Kingdom Connections Youth Ministry. And I am just so excited to have such supportive leaders of our youth ministry. You all come to everything that we have. You support us. You encourage us. And so this is just a little token to say thank you so much for what you do. It means a lot. And keep pressing, and we got your back.
I'm standing here on behalf of the Supermen. We just got a little something here for you.
Giving praises to the Almighty God. I wasn't going to get up because I'm a big crybaby, and I praise Him. It do be tears of joy, but the scripture is amazing. You got me. Okay, it's amazing that she used that scripture today, because this card, it meant a whole lot to me and Brother Fisher, and we use Matthew 10 and 42, that if you can just get a prophet a cold drink of water. You know, the word we give and the sacrifice, that He would bless it. You know, and it's not always I would give Him the world, because this is my niece. And you talk about that stump, and I remember when she brought us in. So we tell this story all the time, and everybody know it. And I never forget when I truly knew that the Lord had touched her life. My sister, Minister Bray, you know, she's down and she's under the weather. So we're praying for her, because the enemy is trying to attack our family with sickness. You know, because everybody in here knows what I've been going through. Okay, I laid in the hospital 38 days. I missed my whole summer. You know, and I remember a lot of things. But first of all, I remember my nephew, my pastor, coming to me, and he looked at me, and he said, all of this around here, that's with the machines and the air pumps and all this stuff going through me. He said, just remember, all of this is not what we put our faith in. And then I thought about her. I'm going to get back to her. And I never forget when I knew that the Lord had truly touched her life. Minister Bray had gotten sick, and at that time she wasn't a minister, but the Lord was working on her. And we all went to see her mother, God rest her soul, my sister. And she got us, and they came and got me, but the Lord had already delivered us, and we had began in our walk. And she came and got us, and she said, when we got outside and we saw the condition that Miss Bray was in, and she said, y'all, she said, come right here. She got our hand and got in a circle. She said, you all, we got to pray her through this. The Lord done brought us through. Now, we got to pray her through this. Now, this the baby. We the aunties. We the old folk. You hear me? But that's when I knew that the Lord had touched her life. But today, you know, I don't have to tell all of my personal business, but my husband and I are going through some things. And this was a sacrificial love offering. And I said, Lord, no matter what, we're going to come today. You know, I've been sitting back there in a little pain, and some of them can hear me say, but I said, and I wrote in this card, you hear me, that if He said we just give you a cold drink of water, I said, this will get you a few cases of water. You hear me? And I asked the Lord, did you take it and bless it as a sacrifice of love? You hear me? A sacrifice of love, because whereas others are blessing me, you understand, no job, no pay, husband got put on probation on his job because them 38 days I'm in the hospital, he laid right by my side. Every night. One night even slept on the floor. Hear me, when the nurses come in and try to get me and go to pulling, he said, no, I got this. But they have prayed for us. That has been our pastor, and all you got to do, and he'll tell me, well, you know, sometime I don't get no signal, so you got to just leave me a message. You know, when I can't get to my own, I know I can get to this one, because this one is mine. Most of the time, I'm to him first, and then I'm to mine. God, help me with this family. Like she said, you just got to tell the truth. But I just want them to let them know that I love them so much, and we done been through a lot, and I love him because he's family now, because, you know, we had some issues. My mother had 5 girls and no boys. When they was talking about this little pretty thing, she been pretty all her life. All her life. I just said, just running our genes. It's just running our genes. You know, that's what I say. It's just in her genes. But either way it go, that's been our baby. And she has been through so much, and she is such a strong young woman. And I love these two to death. When we get in our issues, and Keith just sit there and don't say nothing. Apostle Ross just sit there. He don't say nothing. Because he said, I know y'all. I know all of you all. Because, you know, when a bunch of women get to biggering, he'll just look at us, and he won't say nothing. And sometimes it looks like he see you, and he's just looking through your soul. And you just want to say, oh, I'm so sorry. I love y'all.
To my pastor, amen. First, no, I hope not. To my pastor. Yeah, to our pastor. I thank God for these two peoples that God had allowed me to be a part of their life and they're in my life. But I want to say to my pastor that you appointed me your pastor aid president a couple years ago. And we had a goal set when you did that. But I'm going to let you know this. We haven't yet made that goal. And I'm stepping down in obedience, because you said every 2 years you want to shift it around. Somebody else be the president. But I'm a man, I'm not a quitter, and I don't give up. We had a goal set, Pastor, for you and First Lady. We didn't reach it in my stay, but I tell you, whoever the next president be, they probably gonna think I'm still the president, because I'm gonna work just as hard. Whoever the next president of this past day be, I'm gonna work just as hard, because we got a goal set. Yeah. But I wanna let you know this, Pastor. We wasn't far off. This been the best one yet. We didn't get there. We didn't get to the goal. We weren't far. But I will share, this been the best one. And the best is yet to come. The best is yet to come, preacher. All I'm asking you to do, and I know you will, just hang on in here as our pastor, man. I tell you, we love you. This is the best pastor. I know everybody jumped their pastor. What I'm telling you, y'all pastor got to bring it on. Because I feel like we got the best pastor in Lee County. And the best first lady. And the prettiest first lady in Lee County. Not knocking nobody else, Pastor. When your time comes, you better bounce yours. Cause right now, when your season comes, because today is our season. Yeah. And we love it. I tell you, we just love you, Pastor. We'll get there, man. We'll get there. And we can't pay you for what you do. But I know a man that can. Amen, amen. God bless you, preacher.
To our first lady, love you.
While the picture taken, Apostle, and you just stay right where you are. On behalf of Apostle and Lady Ross and the KCC family, we want to give you this little token to say thank you for allowing God to use you as his vessel today. That's just how we do it.
Amen. Before we close,
I just want to say this because I'm going back to the kitchen. For those of us that was not here Wednesday night, all of our guests will eat first. KCC, end of the line. All of our guests will be served first. We got plenty. We have plenty of food. But we just need to know that our visitors will be first. KCC, and when they finish, fall in line and we're going to eat together. All right.
Amen. Before our pastors come with our remarks, Minister Corey has a word. Amen.
Amen. Woman of God spoke and confirmed something for me on this evening, and I want to repent for not moving. Amen. This morning, I was in prayer, and the scripture came to me. Peter, thou lovest me, feed my sheep. And God began to deal with the sheep and the shepherd. The sheep, the thing about us as sheep, we are dumb animals. Sheep will follow each other, even into danger, right off the cliff. And that's why they need a shepherd to lead them. But not only do you have a shepherd, and a shepherd have a staff, but then you have sheepdogs. The sheepdogs are gathered around a shepherd to help keep the sheep together. And I didn't understand what the Lord was speaking to me this morning. But the woman of God confirmed something 2 years ago. Woman of God spoke to you, Pastor. And he says God had given a vision to two other pastors. And because of their disobedience, the anointing was no longer on them. But God spoke and said that it shall come to pass because of you. And God showed me where our leaders. Our leaders stand. We are your sheepdogs. Leaders, we're not here to sow discord amongst the sheep. We're not here to sleep with the sheep. We're not here to even be friends with the sheep, because they need us to be the sheepdogs. They need us to be his eyes and his ears, his arms and his legs. Thou lovest me, feed thy sheep. Pastor and lady, will you stand? I began in prayer this morning to question the Lord. Lord, why do I feel the way I feel sometimes when things are out of order, or when people vex me or hurt my feelings, or when people don't believe in me? God, why is I'm allowed to feel what I feel? And Pastor, I carry your spirit, so I feel what you feel. I come to encourage you on this evening that, Pastor, we got your back. Lady, we got your back. Pastor, we're holding your arms up so we all can win. And it shall come to pass. It may tarry, but it will come to pass. Don't get weary in your well-doing. Sometimes we're disobedient. Sometimes you have to reprimand us. But don't get weary in your well-doing. Sometimes you have to do without, for the sake of the ministry. But God spoke it to you, And it shall come to pass. If we can pray for our pastors. Leaders, point your hands towards our pastors. Most gracious and heavenly Father God, we thank you for our man of God and our woman of God. We thank you, God, for the vision that you've given them. Thank you for them being the protectors of our anointing, Father God. Thank you for the times that they have to pastor us, God, even when it doesn't feel so good, God. God, thank you for the outpouring of love, God, the text messages, God, the fathering us, the mothering us, God. Thank you, Lord God, that it's meant for our good. Even when we don't understand, because you didn't speak it to us. You spoke it to them, God. So, God, give us a spirit of obedience, God, that we'll move at their command, God, that we'll submit to authority, God. We will know authority. We would recognize authority. God, we repent for every time that we've been lazy, every time we've been slowful, every time we've made an excuse, every time we have not been good stewards over our word or over our prayer life or over fasting, God, or even just tending to the flock, Father God. God, we repent today. And God, we lift up our pastor and our first lady, Father God. God, that there would be no discouragement among them, Father God. God, I pray that they would just feel the love, God. God, feel the love and the encouragement from their leaders, God, knowing that their leaders got them and covering them, Father God. God, let us buy into the vision that you've given our pastor, because it's a faith walk. We haven't seen it. God, we believe, but help our unbelief. Help our unbelief. Let it be moved as far as the east is from the west, God. God, give them strength for the journey. God, bless their marriage, their union, their children, their grandchildren, their finances, God. God, their friends, their family, their loved ones, everything about them, Father God. God, we pray for generational blessings to come and just overtake them, God. In the name of Jesus, let the mind of Christ continue to be in them. Fiery hedge of protection around them, Father God. And God, now that we as leaders have repented, show us a better way. Show us when to speak, when to be silent, Father God. Ignite the fire that is in us, that we will come and we will bow down at the man of God, and we will allow him to circumcise us, God. We will allow him to cut away any excess baggage that should not be. We will show ourselves to the man of God. And we would not complain. We would not leave in anger, but we'll leave in love. God, we thank you and we praise your name. In Jesus' name, amen.
What a God-appointed anniversary. Amen. At this time, we'll have our remarks from Apostle and Lady Ross. Amen.
This may be the first year that I'm speechless. Because I am a woman of words. Many words. But you know, just in his presence. Just in his presence. And just to see the love of so many people, you know. Some people I don't even know, but I still feel your love. And we do appreciate you so much. You know, it just did something to me because, like my aunt said, I have two aunts here. My aunt Donna, she's my oldest aunt, and my aunt Linda and her husband, my uncle Jerry. And it did my heart, it did something to me because to see the, what, you know, she was so ill for so long, and then to see her press her way. The prayers of the righteous truly availeth much. And then I have another aunt who wanted to be here, so, and you all know Sister Jo. And then see what she wasn't here, but that's okay because God always have a ram in the bush. And then when I see my aunts here, I'm like, every anniversary that we have, anything we have, I always think of my mother. because she was such a part of this church and she believed in this ministry. Because like Elder said, in the beginning, we could have all sat on one pew, the founding members. But when God called you out to do a thing, he calls you out without you to have to question it. And it was questionable. I have to say that I was a Sarah, you know, on the outside of the tent, like laughing within myself. But you know, who are we to say what God has said? Who are we to question? This has been such an anointed service. It has been a woman of God. You have blessed us in more ways than you can. CTS, we love you. You have blessed us mightily. Everybody who had a part in this service. And we do, and you know the little thing, we don't know that selfies mean a lot, Sister Puntu. We're just real, just regular, ordinary people. And we don't do it. We don't expect, but we know that you all want to bless your man of God. And, you know, like, y'all don't have to. We don't want to tie you out. We just regular, you know. it's just regular for us. It's just regular. And we do love you. And we truly do love you and thank you for everything that you've ever done. And it's not easy. From the media, you all just don't know how vital you are in this ministry. When people come in here, they are just in awe of what you do. And I'm like, I don't know. All I can do is press record and do this. But you all mean so much. Our ushers, you say we didn't do much. You all just don't know how important you are, ushers. And you all are so faithful, and we love you. You're faithful. Even I say, look at where did our little photographer go? I say, look how he just stepped on in, Casey. Brother Casey, he's been with us for a minute. You know, take it. That's our photographer. But you know, it just means so much in our leaders. Y'all know we link up. We just link up all over this church. We started as a family, and we have grown, but we're still a family. There are some who may not be here. A lot of them are over there in the kitchen because they're doing what they have been called to do. So don't get it twisted. Everybody has a part to play, and everybody has been playing their part, and we love everybody from the parking lot to the back door. God is so good. He's just good. And we just love you, and we thank you. We thank you, and I just can't say enough that we just thank you. And, you know, Minister Hill said that, you know, the best is yet to come. We say it every year, and guess what? The best is still yet to come because every round, the word of God, every round goes higher and higher. Why stand still and be stagnant? We're supposed to be reaching to higher, higher, deeper depths, longer, farther with the Lord. And this is not for shape. Y'all know I used to mock Sister Charzetta over there. I'm going to say, we're going to come in here one day. We're going to have our own anniversary. We're going to have on some overalls and a white T-shirt and some cowboy boots. On our anniversary, I said, oh, y'all going to have Sister Chazetta clutching her pearls. Because y'all know me, I'm just real. Regardless of what they may say, I'm so confident. I am so confident in who I am. Now, they may say all manners are evil, but I am confident in who I am, and I'm so comfortable in my own skin. I can't be nobody but me. And I thank you all, Kenny Connections Church, for allowing me to be me. Amen. I love you. Love you. God bless you. This is probably a first as well. Something different about this service. It's the anointing. It's the anointing. And when you have a spirit that's conducive to his spirit, that it's not a shape, form, or fashion, you know, it does something to you. What comes from the heart truly reaches. And you can feel, you know what's real. You know what's real. You know what's real and what's fake. We done been around. I was churchy. We all been churchy. But it's time to get real. It's time to get real. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You know how the enemy, he tries to tear you down. Yes, it's only been 12 years. It's okay, because 12 seems like 12,000 sometimes. When we were celebrating with Apostle McKenzie, you know, and the journey hasn't been easy. It's never easy. But why would he give you something that's easy? But he gave you the will and the power to do. He equipped you to do it. So like the word of God this morning, you got to pick up your cross. And that cross is, sometimes that cross is heavy. It's heavy. But you got to go on in Jesus' name. Amen. This is the oldest member of our church. This is Aunt Beck. This is Apostle Ross's aunt, his mother's sister, and the oldest member of our church, Rebecca, Aunt Beck.
Amen. Praise God. Come on, clap for Jesus. Amen. We thank God for all of the gifts, all of the auxiliaries, the leaders, the visitors, the pastors and preachers that came to be with us. Most certainly our special guests, our Pastor A committee, our MC. We could just go on and on. The musicians, our extra musicians, the photographer, the media ministry, the people that cook, we show enough. Thank God for you. Amen. We're just thankful. Woman of God, you have poured out mightily. Today is such a big day for us. And we know, like we said, those little selfies and the little things we do with our leaders are important. But it has been a very big day. Our woman of God does need to get some food back in her. Amen. The best thing we can do is when we dismiss, if you would allow me to escort our pastors over to our fellowship hall. When you want to fellowship with them, if you'll meet them over there, but let us get them seated and them served. Amen? Amen. Amen. First things first. Praise God. And all our visitors, don't nobody leave. We got enough food. We believe in eating around this place. Amen. Amen. Praise God.
Amen. We just thank God for the day and everything my wife said. You know, I couldn't say it any better, but I just thank God for all the love. And, I want to thank my mother and my father. Because this really didn't start here. It started at my parents' home. And when God told me to go, they went with me. And they stayed with me. And they still with me. Now, that don't mean much to you, but that means a lot to me. So I just want to thank God for my mother and father for being there for me all my days. All my days. So many people to thank. My wife had thanked pretty much everybody. But I'm just thankful for this year. And I don't know what it is, but I guess, like she said, just the anointing. All day. There's been an anointing here. And we just thank everybody that came out to show love and And let's go continue to fellowship together. And don't tell nobody I was over here crying and carrying on. Oh, let's stay in the kingdom, right here in the kingdom. Amen. But these are tears. I mean, but these are tears of gratitude and thankfulness. Amen. For all that God has done and all that God has done through you as well. Amen. So we thank God for you, and let's go in fellowship and eat together. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Bishop Thomas, come on.
Before everybody go to take off, I wouldn't have missed this day for all the tea in China. And on the third Sunday in October, Apostle Ross is going to be back out, because I hate when folks say, I'm going down to Gaza. You ain't going down nowhere. He's going to be out preaching for us on the third Sunday for my secretary. She's my cousin, been with me all these years. She's been through a serious battle physically last two or three Sundays. She hadn't been at church. And when she's not at church, you know that it's serious. And I prayed about who I wanted, and I got in touch with Corey. Because if I know that I want to catch up with him, all I got to do is catch up with Corey. And so he agreed. So the third Sunday, he's going to be out with us at God's House of Prayer, and we pray.